Bitch, I'm running.
We gon' run it up.
Bitch, I'm running.
We gon' run it up.
Spend it all.
We gon' run it
up. I might just spend it all.
We gon' run it up.
Here today, but gone tomorrow. I just might spend it all.
We gon' run it up.
I just might spend it all.
We gon' run it up.
I might just spend it all.
We gon' run it up.
Here today, but gone tomorrow.
We gon' run it up.
I might spend it all.
We gon' run it up.
I just might spend it all.
We gon' run it up.
I might just spend it all.
We gon' run it up.
Here today, but gone tomorrow. I might spend it all.
We gon' run it up.
He off the dope. We off it. We off the boat.
Long ass walkway. I usually opt out and do like the pat down, but they just put me through the metal detectors. So I was like, all right, whatever. I'm one of those people. That radiation shit is terrible for you. I gotta run a game of smash speed.
Devices should be holders. Your next level of care on every flight. Although CDC guidance has changed. And once again, welcome aboard.
So one day pass is $5 for adult?
Yeah, and then $2.50 for 2.5 hours.
All right, we're trying to figure out the transit card thing. So our main mode of transportation this trip is walking, public transportation, and then like the occasional Lyft Uber, which I'm totally cool with doing. Right now, since we can't check in yet, I'm gonna run some errands, pick up some booth, get some sunscreen, grab some Joe, maybe some donuts, stuff like that. So what happens when you tap it?
Tapping is the same thing as buying a card, and it's like if you tap it twice, it covers the whole day. That's why I took $2.50 the first time I tapped it, but that only covers 2.5 hours.
Ah, okay. So we're ordering from this place, Oregon, Portland. You can order for pickup. Looking at the pre-rolls, so they got this one's on sale, so I'm gonna snag that. Another pre-roll, apple fritter, that sounds fire. Horchata, caked up cherries.
No, don't get the caked up cherry one.
It's trash.
Doesn't sound good.
What about the other ones? Banana. I'm getting banana runs because it's on sale.
What do you have so far?
Oh, you know what? I can get two of those. Remove the
kicked
up.
Is that horchata?
Yeah, it's horchata. But I'd rather get like two of the ones that are on sale. But that's the price.
Yeah.
So $46.40 for 6 J's. I'm gonna pick them up right now. Hey Jian, your order has been submitted. Ready for pickup at 10:30.
We have arrived. Aura grown. The booth pack is all in here. I gotta get a lighter though. So Voodoo Donuts is a 5-minute walk. We're gonna hit it,
just for the hype. And no, I'm not expecting much, but we'll go.
What's going on, guys? We're back here again. Today we're heading up Portland, Oregon. We're gonna check out these donuts at Voodoo Donuts, and we're gonna hit up Snow Bunny Cafe very quickly. That's the start of the trip.
Here we are, Voodoo Donuts. The store itself is kind of cool.
Yes.
Up close for you guys. These donuts actually look pretty cool. Looking pretty crazy. And that rainbow one. One of those cannolis. Look at that. M&M. That's how you do it.
Which one?
Try it. Just grab like four or six donuts.
Can I get the Voodoo Dome? Please raspberry dough, is that okay? Yeah, that's fine. What is that purple one right there?
You think four is enough?
Add a 20. Did you need a receipt?
About to try the donuts. It's time to give these donuts a taste test. What should I try first? So, we got the, I don't know what this one is with the pretzel.
The Voodoo.
Is that a dick?
No, it's a Voodoo.
Oh, my God, I gotta stick mine then. Apple fritter. This is the raspberry Romeo and then the mango tango. Which one should I try first?
Mango tango.
Mango tango? Oh, no, this is the mango tango. Mango tango. Looking crazy. What's mango about it? What do you think? That thing is really thick. Look how thick that is.
Look at the centimeter. What does it taste like?
It tastes like very generic donut that you can probably get at like 7-Eleven. It don't really taste mango either. Alright, for this trip, we'll rate it out of 10 for quick maths. This donut, in particular, I'm gonna have to give it like a 4 out of 10. This ain't anything special. Alright, I guess I missed it. There's more mango right here. Oh, good. Spoke too soon. I'll redact the 4, change it to like a 7. We're gonna go rapid fire. I'm just gonna take a bite out of each and give you a rate. This is the Voodoo one. It's like a long drawn, right? Is that what it's called?
It's a Voodoo. It's called Voodoo Donut.
6 out of 10. Apple fritter. I love apple fritters. It's huge. It's bigger than my hand. Size, 6.5 maybe. We need more like apple chunks or something. Blueberry Romeo. This thing looks crazy. Mm. 7.5. Nothing's exceeded an 8 yet. Voodoo Donuts. Like a tourist spot, really, I think. Okay, so I've come to the conclusion that Voodoo Donuts is comparable to like Stan's in Chicago. And just to clarify, I'm not shitting on Voodoo Donuts. They're like solid donuts. They're just not like, they're not blowing me out of the water or anything. I feel like I've had better donuts. We got one left. Honestly, these donuts are fat as hell.
Help out.
This guy's pissed because all I did was take a bite and rate the donuts. This guy's eating his third donut right now. Trolley now, headed to get some coffee. So it's nice to just sit down now, just chill out for a bit. You already know why we came to Snow Bunny Cafe. Who doesn't like a snow bunny? Ooh. Iced Americano with an extra shot. What is this one?
Strawberry latte.
Strawberry latte. Tastes good.
Tastes good. This is something I'm not used to.
Tastes good.
We've literally been sitting here for like an hour now. Took a fat shit too. 2 more hours till we can check in, but I think we're gonna start heading that way. I need to pick up some sunscreen, some water, beers, some brews. There's also a bookstore, I forget what it's called, it starts with a K. It's like a Japanese bookstore that I've been to when I lived in Tokyo. We kind of tweaked because Portland's about to experience a heat wave, so Saturday and Sunday are like 107 and 112, so I need to make sure I have water and sunscreen on me at all times. That's the game plan right now. We're like high-key just like fucking loitering here. I mean, we bought shit, but still.
Do you guys do this with your water bottles? I mean, I hardly drink plastic, but when I do, this is what I do. I know that many people aren't wearing masks anymore, but another benefit to wearing masks is that my face doesn't get rinsed by the sun, bro. I need to pick up some sunscreen badly. This car, tough. I'm stopping by for every cool car that I see and taking a film picture. First stop. So this is the sunscreen that we're getting. SPF 25. I think I'm gonna pick up the shampoo.
It's pretty nice chatting with the dude at Aesop. I was just asking him about some spots here and stuff. Nice guy.
My whole back is drenched right now. Woof. It was bamboozled. Can you guys see how sweaty this shit is? I might have to just throw this shirt like away. Nah, I'm just kidding. Sustainability. Gonna scoop up some claws. What flavors do you guys fuck with?
Ooh.
Mango's usually decent. What is that one? Lemon tangerine and...
Lemon tangerine, watermelon and mango.
Sounds like a winner. I think we're going with that one, the Good and Gather. It's cheaper, it looks decent. Bottled water, man. Fuck me.
For welcome, and an item to begin.
Alright, bro. We just checked in and I'm waiting for the room. It's a complimentary cocktail for check-in. So, this is some sort of like rum drink. Alright, we're in a temporary room. I don't know why the fuck our shit isn't ready, but we have a dinner, or not a dinner, but like a lunch, like a late lunch reservation at 4:30. I'm gonna like wash my face and shit. I'm gonna show you guys what I picked up from the dispensary though, real quick. Alright. The seal? What is this seal right here?
Hey, button.
Okay, hold this. Alright, so you just push this forward and then... There you go. So these are all in canisters. I bought a bunch of J's. This one, Runts and Horchata, Apple Fritter. These were the discounted ones. Where's the flavor at?
Something
up emoji.
303
OG. This one, same thing. 303 OG. Banana Runts. So, I need to buy a lighter. Just kind of chilling out a little bit before we head out. I have like a bit of a headache, a little bit, probably from dehydration, and then like it's hot out. But anyway, wanted to share my philosophy on boof. So I don't have a problem with it. I would never shame anybody. I don't see any issue with it. It's legal, right? My thing is that if I'm going to smoke, I like to have like moves surrounding the session, you feel me? So like reservations, dinner reservations, like just like
plans, you know? I would not just smoke and then like go to the gym or like go do homework or like do something where I have to like focus, because like that to me, it does like, if I'm smoking, I'm trying to like wind down, you know, not like get work done. That's what Adderall's for, you feel me? And then if, you know, I'm just gonna explain the how like the payment is for public transit here, because it was a bit confusing at first. So let's say you pay $2.50 or $2.75. That goes for like 2.5 hours. So you tap it once, and then every time you get on like a bus or a train, you tap it again, but it won't charge you if you're within that 2.5 hour time frame. It's once you're outside of that 2.5 hour time frame is when they'll charge you again. So that was a bit confusing, because I thought I didn't have to like tap because it's still been 2.5, but they need to verify that you're still within 2.5 hours. You get me? The ring is on. Not bad, right? Got the hand sanitizer in the elevator. The first spot, my first reservation. Got the set meal and then chilled sake, and they just brought us some edamame. Alright, we have a miso soup, coconut prawns, and then the edamame. I'm just gonna dig in. Alright, coconut prawns. So I couldn't taste the coconut at first, but I just realized the brown parts, that those are coconut shavings. So I taste it now. Fire as fuck. So I'll just came in. I'm seeing baby tomato, I'm seeing radish, I'm seeing some romaine lettuce, some tuna. Looks proper. Here's the salad up close. Shisharuni. This first spot is already a hit, bro. So good. This is just complimentary too. Miso soup. That depth of flavor, man. Maybe I'm burning the miso or something. I can't achieve this at home. Alright, I'm going in on the salad. These are definitely tomatoes. Some sashimi. The lemon. It's like some ponzu in there or something. Something acidic. So fresh. Wow. Feeling dumb as hell. I was putting the empty edamame skin on my plate. She's like, bro, this cup is what it's for. We have our hand rolls. We have some side dishes. Salmon and salmon belly. The toro and toro belly. And then we have the tuna. We have, I think that's white tuna. The wasabi. Another hand roll. And then the ebi. Oh. Another roll right here. Fire roll.
Man. So we.
Alright. You wanna do the chilled sake shots real quick? Cheers with them.
Kanpai.
Kanpai. Bites. Camera ate first on this. I'll give you the best bite right here, the toro. And then I'm gonna have to savor this with the little belt. Here's the toro, tuna belly. I'll hit a little bit of salt, just a tad.
Come on, bro. I'll give you the tempura too, all right? Don't say I don't look out for you guys. I haven't had proper tempura since Japan. How the fuck do they make vegetables taste this good?
Yo, I was skeptical at first that there wasn't real wasabi, but the texture of this wasabi, I already know this is real wasabi. They went crazy here.
Anyone who doesn't know, this is sushi ginger, this is pickled carrots, and this is ume. FYI.
I keep saying that's enough, but I'm taking you guys with me. This bite right here. Fresh wasabi, the radish. Put some soy on there.
That's crazy because this isn't even omakase level yet. There's levels to this shit, bro.
Salmon belly, are you shitting me right now?
This is the absolute last thing you guys are gonna get. I'm spoiling you guys.
And that's a wrap.
Here's Low Bro's fit check. So that dinner was insane. We're going back to the hotel because there's 6 VZs waiting for us. And if we don't boof one today, then that's 6 left for 4 days. I'm not a mathematician, but that shit don't add up, fam. So we're gonna get a lighter, get the boof in, and then I'm gonna show you guys our dinner reservation for tonight. I'm just gonna peep this Nike real quick.
This?
Kyrie's got his own weathermans.
These are sick.
They are sick, right?
For a way, they look like kind of a Kobe's.
Look at PG's PlayStation collab. These are disgustingly, like, these are abysmal. The design is trash. They gave us the right room now. Got somewhat situated. So this is where I'm gonna be sleeping. Little bro sleeping on the bunk above. Then we got the 55 inch right here. This man had that crazy ass dunk last game to win it. Sheesh. It's third with 5 to go. We're gonna be late for this reservation. We don't get going. I think we're gonna go with the banana runs cause that doesn't sound too good. So you wanna finish the worst one first. Let's get her going. Running a little late. It's gonna be an 8-minute walk, which is optimal time for a little bit of boof. Wait, so we're early then, right?
Yeah,
because
we're supposed to get on at 8:09, but it's 8:55.
Well, I'll be damned. Oh, what is that? Oh, neat. I'm so happy, like, we have been able to commute wherever we wanted to go, I guess, for lack of better wording, via the train and the bus and public transit and walking, which I absolutely loved to do back when I was in Japan. More about the public transit here. Once you've tapped the hop card twice, which is like $5, then you meet the threshold and you no longer have to pay for the day. So you commute for free for the rest of the day once you hit $5, basically. That is insane. Chicago, if you take the CTA, it's like $2.50 to get on, and then even transfers are like 75 cents. That is so crazy. Oh shit, look at that little like park full of food buses. I have to hit that up tomorrow or something. All right, it's time to spark up, you feel me? Ooh, just throw that in the... I'll get a hit too. All right, another little story time about a Fury. So a Fury is this ramen chain. based out of Japan. I used to hit it up like blackout drunk after a night in Roppongi, and that shit would smack. I think there's a video out with, like, that's an old one. Pharrell says this is his favorite spot too. They just make a solid ass bowl of ramen. I don't know why they stationed them here in Portland, but can't even wait. Got a little head high going. This was $15. It's Japanese whiskey. Bro, look at this. Fuck me, man. Huh? Look at this shit, bro. Try the broth first. Holy fuck. This is the exact recipe. Fuck. Dude, this broth is the exact recipe. We were tweaking because I was like tip on the subtotal, but I forget there's no tax here in Portland, so the total is a subtotal. All right, a Fury in Beaverton. The broth, they did not miss a beat. They followed that recipe to the T. The noodles though were a little, I think, undercooked for my liking. And then the chashu was just like way too thin. It was like a slice of ham. I was like, what the fuck? It's supposed to be thick as a patty. So those are my critiques. I'm fucking dying right now. We got here and we're like, can you guys have some toothpaste? Because we didn't see any in the bathroom. And then I was trying to redeem the free cocktail. And then they said the bar is closed, so I'm like, you guys have ice? And you hooked it up with a bucket of ice. But I'm dying because it was just like a fucking free water asking for a bunch of shit. You know what it is. Claw is the law. I think, what's your favorite flavor, guys? Tangerine seems solid. I like mango. This one's tangerine. I think I'm gonna do a tangerine.
Is there anything I can do to throw him off his game?
Dynamite in the burger.
More subtle.
C4.
Move off explosives.
Habanero pepper.
Just chilling, just relaxing, watching some TV. Just took a shower. Covered a lot of ground today. Hit the dispensary, hit Voodoo, hit Snow Bunny, hit Aesop, hit Target. Had our solid ass lunch reservation. Came back, boofed. Had a solid ass dinner reservation. This is just the beginning. This is the tip of the iceberg. We haven't even scratched the surface yet. Like, manifesting it is gonna be my best vlog. For sure, best travel vlog. We're gonna come hella correct this time. Last time, there was some capri going on. We'll not be making that mistake this time around. So, I'll see you guys tomorrow.